How's it, everyone? Welcome to another racket review right here on OpenCourt. So today I'm testing out a racket that I've actually never used before. It has been recommended to me by a few people, but I've never gotten around to use it. So I thought it was about time for me to review the Wilson Ultra 100 version 4. So before we get into this review, be sure to overhead smash that like and subscribe button if you like this content to keep the reviews coming. Let's check out the Wilson Ultra 100. So this is the version 4 of the Wilson Ultra, I guess fourth generation, which is surprising to me because it feels like the Ultra line just recently released, but I guess that's not the case. I've never used any racket in the Ultra series before. This, as you guys probably know by its blue color, is the direct competitor to the Babala Pure Drive line. This is the power line in the Wilson family. I'm kind of disappointed that I never got around to trying the Wilson Ultra 95, and I'm kind of sad that they never included a 95 in the current version 4 lineup, because that's the racket that Kei Nishikori, one of my favorite players, endorsed. That's not the racket he actually used, but those specs were a little bit more towards my liking. But regardless, the Wilson Ultra 100 I know is popular for its easy power, and so what is new with the version 4 of the Ultra? Well, Wilson has added their proprietary 45 technology, if you guys can see here. The 45 technology was first introduced in the first generation of the Wilson Clash. It was the Clash's proprietary technology. Wilson has since branched out and included it in the Ultra lineup, as well as, I believe, the Blade lineup. So the 45 technology gives these Wilson rackets its unique feel and flex. It'll bend a little bit differently compared to other rackets on the market, giving it a better stability and more comfort. Another update to the Ultra 100 is that it has a slightly thinner beam. We'll get into the specs later, but even though it is a little bit thinner, you guys can see this is a pretty beefy frame, as it should be because it is the power racket of the Wilson family. And lastly, a unique feature to the Ultra lineup is the crush zone grommet system located down here in the throat. So it has a very interesting and unique grommet design that is meant to compress at the moment of impact, giving the main strings in the center a little bit more power and dwell time. This elongated vertical sweet spot supposed to obviously increase the power, hence the name crush zone. And lastly, I just want to point out that I really like the updated paint job of this Wilson Ultra. It has a unique sleek matte finish that reflects light in different ways, so I don't think you can use it to distract your opponent. I don't recommend you do that, that's bad sportsmanship, but this is a really cool, nice paint job, and so far it's my favorite paint job of the Wilson Ultra line. So let's take a quick look at the specs of the Wilson Ultra 100 version 4. As you guys can see, there's nothing too special or unique with the specs. It's 100 square inch, 300 grams unstrung, same as the Pure Drive, 320 millimeter balance. The beam thickness, the 24.25 was listed on one of the sites that I researched. The other sites listed at 25 millimeters down at the throat. I don't know which one is actually true, but regardless, the beam is supposed to have been thinned this time around, but it's still, like I said, pretty thick and beefy. And the last thing I want to point out is that 70 stiffness rating. That seems pretty high. The Pure Drive and these thick framed rackets historically have a high stiffness, but I do believe the 45 will reduce that harsh stiff feel. So I don't think this racket is actually going to feel like a 70 RA racket. But that is one thing that I will be looking for in this playtest. So enough chit chat, let's get on the court. Let's see if this racket gives me the power to blow away my opponents. All right, guys, I'm here on court with the Wilson Ultra 100 version 4. So I've never used any racket in the Ultra line, so I'm excited to finally get out on the court and try this Ultra 100. Let's see how this plays. Oh, wow, okay. It has a lot of pop. Oh yeah, geez, easy depth. I guess I shouldn't be surprised. It's the Pure Drive of the Wilson lineup, but it actually is. It does feel a little bit stiff actually, but it's probably not quite up to a 70 RA. But I definitely noticed that shock on impact, especially if I hit off center. The launch angle is really, really high. I like it on the backhand because my backhand is slightly flat, so I hit a lower trajectory anyway. Oh man, easy depth on the slice though. Not as much spin on the slice as I would like with like an 18-20 that stays low and skidding, but it gets it deep. And easy power on those high ground strokes. Oh, when I strike the sweet spot though, it's solid, powerful. The control is decent, it's not great, but it's an ultra racket. If you're coming here for control, you're in the wrong racket. The power is definitely where this racket shines. I apologize for the wind and the rain, guys. It's been raining so much recently in Hawaii, but what I gotta do to get reviews for you guys. When I strike it cleanly though, it feels great. So much power, oh yeah. Power rackets are generally not my cup of tea because I have an aggressive swing, but definitely if I can control the power and get it in the sweet spot, it adds to my aggressive game. So it's a trade-off that I might have to take every now and then. Okay, so at the net here, this is where I was actually really looking forward to this playtest, because 100 square inch rackets are my go-to when it comes to doubles. It gives me that extra real estate at the net. So far, man, this thing packs a punch. Yeah, on that low volley, all I really have to do is just block it back. Feels so comfortable and powerful. Oh! This racket does lack a little bit of mobility, maneuverability at the net. I feel it's a little bit sluggish, but it has so much leeway in terms of the sweet spot that even if I catch it slightly late, it still has a decent amount of punch. Ah! Yeah, there we go. Yeah, serving and volleying is what I'm really looking forward to with this racket. I like 100 square inches on the serve and volley. More power on the serve, more power, easy net clearance on the volleys, easy put away. This racket actually does have a decent amount of feel, but on the volleys it definitely feels a little stiffer than some other rackets I've tried recently. Which I like stiff rackets, it gives me that response and the touch to hit angles and drop shots, so I'm not complaining. All right guys, I just wrapped up my play test of the Wilson Ultra 100 version 4, and boy, this thing packs a wallop. Which isn't surprising considering this is the power line of the Wilson family. So let's get into the pros and cons of the Wilson Ultra 100 version 4. So let's start out with the pros of the Wilson Ultra 100 V4. And I gotta be honest, there weren't too many things I liked about this racket. I really wanted to like it, but just like most tweener power rackets I try, like the Pure Drive and Pure Aero, these types of power frames just don't conform to my playstyle. We'll touch on that later. First things first, the power level on this frame is really high. I guess that won't be a surprise to most people. Where this racket really shined is on the serve. The serve was easily my favorite shot to hit with the Ultra 100. Super easy power on flat serves, easy net clearance on the slice serves, and a decent amount of topspin on the kick serves. I could mix it up and attack my opponent with varying spins and pace, which made following my serve into the net really easy, and it forced weak returns that my partner or I could attack. I really appreciate any racket that can up my service game because my kick serve is really the only serve I'm confident in. I would really like to add more pace on my flat serves, but my height limits my power, so I'll take any help I can get. The Ultra 100 definitely gave me that help. The Ultra 100 was also really stable. Typically, these 100 square inch thick beam rackets are good in the stability department, and when I did get the racket in place in time, especially on those reflex volleys, the racket rarely fluttered in my hand. Off-center hits I could still hit with a decent amount of pace because of the added stability, which was a welcome bonus. The power also translated well to my net game. I typically enjoy powerful 100 square inch rackets at net for their easy put-away power on the high volleys and overheads, but the Ultra 100 really shines on low volleys. The Ultra assisted with depth and net clearance on those volleys and half volleys I had to dig up off the ground. Lower powered rackets usually clip the net unless I put more effort into the swing. The Ultra made the first approach volley easier than most control rackets I've used. Poaching with the Ultra was also really fun because I could punch the volley for a winner or angle it off without having to really swing, and it goes without saying that overheads had more power than I'm typically used to with my control frames. Groundstrokes were sometimes a bit hard to control, but I really enjoyed the Wilson Ultra 100 on my backhand especially because I swing through more in a line with my backhand. The flatter trajectory kept my ball from sailing long, and I could hit penetrating backhands that didn't lose much velocity after bouncing. The launch angle on the Ultra is pretty high, and it was easy to get depth without swinging aggressively. For those who have slower swings or focus more on depth and spin than racket acceleration and pace, the Ultra 100 will allow you to get that depth you want. In my opinion, the Ultra is a great defensive racket because it will allow pushers to hit deep and pin aggressive players on the baseline. Defensive slices also clear the net at a high clip, and this racket gets pretty decent all-around topspin and underspin on shots. But since I'm more of an aggressive player than a defensive one, there were a number of issues that plagued me during this playtest, so let's get into those now. So the cons list for the Wilson Ultra 100 version 4 is longer than I would have wanted, but to be frank, I wasn't too surprised. I have yet to try a power racket that I really gel with. The biggest issue I had was with the inconsistency I experienced with my forehand ground strokes and returns. There were two main problems. The launch angle was much too high for my swing speed, and I missed a lot of forehand returns long, even when I tried to take off some speed. I sometimes tried to overcompensate and aim lower, which caused me to dump a bunch of returns into the net as well. The second problem I had was with the weight, balance, and feel of the Ultra. Whenever I would take a forehand swing, something just felt off. Have you guys ever had that feeling? My forehand swing just felt really awkward, and in the heat of the moment, that split second of doubt caused me to hit some uncharacteristic mistakes. I especially noticed this on put-away forehands. Whenever my opponent hit a floater and I tried to generate power by taking a bigger backswing, my shots were very erratic and I sprayed balls all over the court. If I can't trust a racket, I don't feel comfortable using it in a heated exchange, and this Ultra 100 just didn't really do it for me. The balance also affected me at the net. Although the Ultra has great put-away power when attacking high, slow balls, whenever I had to hit a reflex volley, the Ultra just wasn't maneuverable enough for me to dig the volley back. I often caught the frame on reflex volleys and I missed a bunch of poaches because I couldn't get the racket up in time to snap my wrist. As a result, I sent a lot of high volleys past the baseline. I couldn't really trust this racket on fast volley exchanges either, and it made me timid at net. That is a foreign feeling for me since I am an aggressive net player. Also, the Ultra 100 is stiff. Originally, I thought the 45 tech in the racket would dampen the feel, but I still felt the stiffness. It didn't bother me, but a 70 stiffness rating will bother a lot of people with sensitive arms. I had this racket strung with a full bed of Wilson NXT 16 gauge, and it still felt a little boardy at times. So if you're thinking of trying this with a full bed of poly, make sure you have some CBD cream handy just in case. So who is the Wilson Ultra 100 V4 for? I believe it's for intermediate level players who are looking for more access to power and spin, but that's the beauty of a tweener racket. Many players can use this with some customization. I think defensive baseliners will also mesh with the Ultra because of its easy depth and net clearance. Powerful servers who want more pace on serves will see that boost in power. Aggressive net players who are stronger than me and want more stability than maneuverability can also make use of this stick. There is a wide variety of players who can use the Ultra line, but unfortunately for me, the launch angle, head heavy balance, and thick beam just isn't really in my wheelhouse. Some people think the Ultra 100 might suit beginners who are looking for a step up racket, but be wary of the stiffness. Those beginners should stay away from full poly with this stiff Ultra. Or just try the Clash 100 because that racket is much softer. So although my first time trying out the Ultra line didn't amaze me the way the paint job did on this racket, I believe the Ultra line justifies its place in the Wilson family. I don't know if I can say the same about the Burn line, but that's a review for another day. So if you haven't tried the new Wilson Ultra, it's a great power racket, so give it a try. Thank you for watching this review of the Wilson Ultra 100 version 4 right here on Open Court. If you guys like this content, be sure to overhead smash that like and subscribe button, and I'll see you on an Open Court.